going forward. He's adjusted to the MP7, trying to farm a little bit of extra cash up against the unarmed players. Can be a very versatile weapon indeed. Very lots of run and gun potential there, and has chews up unarmed opponents. So Luminosity will be coming in with two smokes here. They will be taking the partial buy. Two Tech Nines, two smokes, and see what they decide to do there. I'm trying to think what's going to be the most viable thing. They could do those two smokes towards the long corner and try and retake it, go for the kills there. It's been a heavy area of contention for them. Or simply go for a B-split once again and have two players coming out of the tunnels.
We mentioned this earlier when Anders and I were watching Dust2 as well. There haven't been a lot of mid B-splits in this map today. It seems like most teams are favoring against that, which is, I mean, a lot of it has just been these standard hits onto the A bomb site.
Yeah, it seems like everyone's just trying to work that right now. It seems like it's kind of in trend just to get the smoke down towards city spawn and try and lock down the AWP, but it's always towards Khan and is trying to stifle him with the flashbangs. We are getting back into this one though. It's going to be round number 23. If you're just joining us, this is our final game of the day. It's the best of three.
This is the first map.
And the first map, and the loser of this best of three is actually out of the tournament, which is kind of nuts considering the matchup we have here.
Yeah, absolutely disgusting. And what a time for your star player to come alive and have a big game. Device currently sitting at 23 and 14. Kerrigan and Zipnix are next at 17 kills. On the other side, it's Fallen with 18, Taco at 15, and FNX at 16. Opening kill from Kerrigan, aggressive up mid on this anti-eco, going hunting. Doesn't want to let any kind of tactics come into play. Dupree looked like he had a little bit of a mouse jump there, so...
That's fine though from Kerrigan. Even if he gives that weapon away, it's not like the MP7, like I said, it's very good against unarmed opponents. As soon as you give that into the hands of a terrorist going up against CTs at long range, doesn't really work. But here we go then, LG forcing their way into the B site. Don't really have many options here. It's Invocation being Dupree, mowing them down. Simple and very easy for them to handle as they take 14-9 here. And the money's, like I said, still not great. Three Galils, an AK, and Taco, what's he got remaining? He can buy an AK and armor, that's about it as well. I think it's just working out whether he wants the nades. And actually does.
And Kerrigan's just going to keep the MP7, so a little bit bonus round for him.
As you would call it, the Jaden round, Moses, I think. Is that you that says that?
We're going to have to have words after
this. Oh, no, it's that other guy, isn't it?
That's that one other guy.
That's that other guy.
we won't speak his name.
Well, then here we go. It's going to be LG looking like more of a depot here. Smoke towards Xbox once again. The only AK-47 towards the top of middle. We'll be flashing teammates through towards lower B. He wants to give them some vision there. That pushes back any AWP that's pushed through, but it doesn't stop Device. He gets towards short, takes down Fur, and they've got the man advantage. They've probably gathered what kind of weaponry the terrorists have got here as well, so they can play a very defensive stance here.
And LG's just going to head right up catwalk. It's going to be a shot, Device. Or Dupree, I mean, excuse me. That is absolutely dirty for him to work with. Good spams back in return, but he's done the damage.
See, anyway, boost, we don't really see too often now in CSGO. It's quite predictable, but every now and then, chuck it in there. And these kind of key situations can be very important. Here comes a drop down. No smoke towards city spawn. That's kind of crazy from Taka to jump down in that situation. If you have no smoke when you drop down, you've got about seven different angles potentially CDs be waiting for you. That's pretty much game at this stage. Luminosity did what they could. It's Astralis adjusting and finding that first pick and then funneling.
I'm wondering if maybe because it's so... teammates who had fallen before that was supposed to throw that smoke and he didn't realize that he wasn't going to have it on the execute.
It doesn't make sense regardless. Like, you don't have smoke there, it's almost like a suicide.
I'm just saying maybe he thought that it was going to be thrown. let's help him out a little bit, Henry.
We'll go with that then. He thought the smoke was there. 15-9 and it's going to be Tech-9, CZs, a scout and an AK. Surely we're all going to see some miracle from the Brazilians here. This would be absolutely gutting for Astralis to throw away. This is the perfect opportunity to finish this one off. You can see that this is the problem though with Astralis. We always talk about it. When they get in touching distance, they can taste the victory. That's when they start to turtle up. They stop losing that killer instinct, but it's Dupree finds the first kill. So potentially, I've got over that just now.
Yeah, this does not look like an Astralis that's going to lose its killer instinct at the moment as these last couple rounds have gone, especially against CZ, a Tech-9, and a Scout are three of the four weapons still remaining on the board for Luminosity and Fallen. He's just perched, and if he swings out any wider, it's going to be Scout on AWP, but on Device, the timing doesn't work out.
Here we go then. Device smokes off towards long and backs up, but Fallen, even he hits him, it has to be a headshot here. And Device now, here's the shot. It's going to be aggression here coming in. It's the shot through the box here. Takes down Fallen, but it's Fur to find the kill on towards Zipex now. It's going to be very aggressive, and the bomb will be planted towards short as well.
Yeah, which is scary. It actually got delayed a little bit, so it's not even down yet. So FNX has got to be aggressive to try and bail him out, so he's given up that plant positioning. Not that it was going to do too much to begin with. It was a CZ. Yeah. So Fur's got to do something miraculous, and he's not able to, and now it's all down to FNX, and once again, just too much to go against. It's going to be a 16th round for Astralis. They will take Dust2 and the first map, 16-9. after a very, very strong performance.
I said coming into this one, it's been Luminosity's T-side and Dust 2 has been the one that's actually not been convincing for me when I've watched them online. Sloppy execution, seem to have a lack of an objective. Like we said on Dust 2, that's fine, but you need to be making good mid-round decisions. I didn't really see that happening. Never got control of their economy, really. Their CT was actually fine. It was actually pretty great. Like, they won the half after having a difficult start for the game, and they went 5-0 down and 1-8-7. So their CT is absolutely fine. That's not a problem for me. It's a T-side. I think that's where they need to do most of their work going forward. It seems like that's a real problem.
Yeah, and you know who was cold for them was some of the heavy hitters on the LG side was Cold and Fur, were just hitting at the bottom of the scoreboard with them. 12 kills, I believe. But that is going to be it. We are going to take a break. So we will see you guys for map 2 when we get back.
Touching on, if you may have just joined us and missed what we said coming into this one, of course, when I say we, I'm talking about Sedakist and Yanko, who are joining me. We said, we sat out the scene saying this Vito could not have gone better for Astralis. One of the points you're making, just how strong their Dust 2 can be. Looks like it worked out in their favor. Luminosity not able to make the Dust 2 happen this time.
Definitely, and I said that a big question mark for me was going to be Astralis' CT side, because they were known for having that passive setup with the AWPer towards the car position and always leaving, most of the time leaving a bomb site and then playing retakes. We saw the complete opposite this time around. The device was the one with the AWP towards the A bomb site. He was being aggressive towards catwalk a couple of times. Then they moved him over towards A long. He got the entry kill there. Okay, he was traded, but the point behind it is that Astralis was constantly moving him around. He was constantly switching positions, and Luminosity had to keep guessing all the time where he's going to be.
And was that aggressive defense so integral to their success, Matt?
I think absolutely. And it's a really good point to see device being the primary opera on this map. Because
this angle was dumb, by the way. This is crazy.
This particular shot we're about to see is also crazy. Double flash. I guess it was single. I thought it was two. But either way, that's a crazy shot to hit. Second one as well over the shoulder. Just to go back to the point, though. I mean, this is the map that they've taken the longest time to adapt to device being the primary opera. They were sticking with Cajun B. Originally, they put device in that position. Kerrigan had famously held long. They put him in B, Dupree over to A. They couldn't hold the basic positions without device alone. So then they had to go back to their old setup. Part of him being aggressive paying off in this situation, though, does stem from the fact that Luminosity still looks quite lackluster in their execution, and their default isn't sound. It seems like he's almost catching them off in situations like that where they're not clearing out angles. And this goes back to, I know, and you said at the top of the show, they've been very successful in their Dust 2 trying to evaluate this map, but it's been against North American teams. This level of skill and this level of aggression they haven't seen yet, and I think that device just really took the fight to them and they weren't ready for it at all.
I mean, that's kind of where I want to take this next. Luminosity conceding that map, and they did look rather deflated in their play, Yanko. Is it fair to say that a team that relies quite heavily on strats, when things are a little wonky, when someone isn't quite having their game, they take the hit the most?
I mean, it's hard to say that they mostly rely on strats. I mean, right now, they start off with a looser play style, then they switch to strats if they have to. Something similar to maybe how Fnatic played way back in the ProNex era. We need to take into account that Luminosity did lose both pistols in this game. They were 5-0 down in the first half, managed to bring it back to 8-7 for them with the double AWP setup. Something that would maybe, you know, take as a negative from their play is that they didn't really try to go B at all on their T side. And on this map in particular, if things aren't going your way, you can always go for something simple, maybe have one guy throw nades over A long to try and draw their attention there and maybe walk out mid with four people, right? Use that as a bait, try to bait out a rotation from the CTs, get an entry kill in the beginning of the round, or just go for a fast B split, which is what Astralis did in their T side half. Of course, that crazy round by Cold Zero when he got those two flick shots dismantled that, but in theory, if it weren't for those crazy shots, they would have won that round based off of that one call. So in the end, the result-wise, it does look pretty comfortable for Astralis, mostly thanks to great play from Device with the AWP, but yeah, a bit unfortunate they lost both pistols.
Yeah, and we're going to be talking about where this leaves them in the series, of course, going into Overpass after a quick break. But when we come back, Overpass is the next map, and we're going to be diving into that one to see if we will see a third map. That will be the question that we are indeed asking. So stay with us as we prepare ourselves for map 2. going home, and it is between Astralis and Luminosity. It does feel odd to say in just day one that one of these two titans of CSGO will be going home, and it could very well be on this next map. Overpass is going to be our discussion topic now. Yanko and Sadakist are hanging out with me. Now, just off air, we were sitting there going, this is a good map for both teams, and that's where our discussion will start. I mean, let's just address why it is a good map for both teams. Luminosity first. I mean, I had the pleasure of casting the ridiculous, you know, Na'Vi LG, ridiculous Overpass, which could very well have been one to remember for a lot of fans when they think about this map and Luminosity.
Definitely, and it's been one of the maps that really it seems like they don't pick it that often, but whenever they play it, they're really dominant on it. These two teams played each other at DreamHack Leipzig. They played on Train and Overpass, and Luminosity beat them on Overpass 16-12. We all remember the grand finals at the Major where they beat Na'Vi pretty handily, although it was under, you know, Na'Vi was basically on tilt after how they lost the first game. And on the other hand, for the Astralis team, historically it's been one of their best maps. They had a crazy win streak on it towards the summer, autumn of last year. I think something close to even 20 consecutive wins on the map.
Do you remember that well, Matt? I see you nodding
along.
Well,
it started, that actually started a little bit before that. It was the end of March at the first Star Ladder when they had it was another choke situation for then TSM at the time against Virtus Pro and went into overtime. That was when they finally won it and moved a little further. That was the start of their streak on it. And this is another map for Astralis where they've shuffled things around, but now the device is, they used to go Kerrigan opping, and it would be a debate between whether it was going to go out to go or long or monster. And they would just gamble it every round. And if they got the call wrong, they usually lost the round. Now that they go with a more consistent setup where the op is on device and he's playing a set position, it's a lot more, I think, it just makes more sense. Because if you know where it's going to be, then you know how to play this site in accordance to it. And everyone's more familiar with where they're playing. And I think that since they've done that, they've actually gotten even better on the map. But I mean, the Brazilians are very good in the executions on this map as well. So
this map revolves a lot around having a default and not being picked out by the oppers on the CT side, because B-Rush is something that you can go for, but not really that much. You can do it maybe once or twice a half. So for me, it's going to revolve around the oppers, basically. You know, how good are Device on one hand and Cold Zero and Fallen on the other hand going to be at getting those early picks on the CT side, and in turn on the T side, where, you know, the op duels, and basically will teams be able to save themselves from the aggressive plays and avoid those? Because most of the times on the CT side, you play the body system, right? You go either for long or maybe for toilet control, stairs control, right? You can't have everything at the same time. So the CT side, mobility on the CT side, and the reaction from the Ts to that is going to be the name of the game here.
The name of the game. And with that said, are we going to see a third map, Matt, first?
Yeah, I think we will. I think we have to watch the B site. Astralis is known for having a really good B hold, but Luminosity will get through there, and I think they'll do it quite convincingly. Train will be a brawl, but this is going to be a third map.
Third map it is. Yanko, you think the same?
Has to be. I predicted LG to win. Please, third map.
Okay, there we go. He's staying true to his prediction, as a good analyst should, believing in Luminosity. He doesn't look like his face is quite telling the same.
Because predictions are everything.
Yeah, evidently. Absolutely. That determines a good from a bad analyst. But still, it is time for Overpass. This could be it. This could be the end of the road for defending major champions Luminosity after conceding Dust 2. They could fall out of what is a ridiculous prize pool. Over $5,000 on the line, and they could very well be going out in groups. It's a crazy storyline, and let's see if Astralis can do it here or if it'll be decided on Train. Let's jump into it.
Astralis, Luminosity. Both teams facing elimination, but Luminosity is down 0-1 in this series.
They don't look phased yet, though. We just saw them in the little intermission there, still pumped, still having the huddles, all the noise coming from that side of the, yep. the stage here. They know they're still not out of it, but obviously a map that's very good for both teams going to this one. It's very hard to separate them. Like, the guys are kind of grasping over there, trying to work out which way it'll go. It does really come down to who's stepping up best on their day. It looks like Astralis, in terms of Dust 2, they look like they're the ones actually stepping forward and actually hitting the shots, but it's a map that Lumos don't really play, so it's really hard to take that much away from that.
That was the map where, of all three of these, you would say that Luminosity had the biggest disadvantage, if anything.
Indeed. Well then, it looks like we're getting into this one, ladies and gentlemen. It is going to be the second map, the best of three. Astralis versus Luminosity. We are on Overpass, and we'll see. It's going to be Luminosity on the Terror side here. Four sets of armor and Fallen with the smoke and two flashbangs.
We saw the pistol win percentages up on the screen just briefly. It would be important. It would be nice for Luminosity to grab at least one on this map. They lost both on Dust 2, and this time it's going to be fast right past the fountain. They're running right into a triangle setup, though. First kill goes to them, so does the third. But good trade so far from Astralis, and Taco jumping, a hard target to hit, is going to allow Fallen to clear him out.
Yeah.
What an explosion from LG.
Yeah, they're sticking together. They do have those four sets of armor, and they do get the man advantage occasionally, and Zipex remain. They have got a kid in the smoke, and he's actually headshot Fallen as well, so they do manage to get something out of this. But right now, it's up to Luminosity to slow things right down and just take that vision away from the CTs, keep them second-guessing, and see if they can get them to separate at this point.
It's actually very, very important, deceptively important, that Fallen gets brought down to 2 HP, but survives falling back. He's got a smoke and a flash.
Yeah, that's the main thing here. So they can probably smoke off. If it's towards bank or CT spawn, they have options here. Just don't want to. This is called a contact play right now. They don't want to actually give anything away or show what they're doing until they absolutely have to. They want to see if they can find the CT, then explode onto the site, get as close as they possibly can, potentially go to bomb down before even making contact with the counter-terrorists there.
Yeah, and Zipnix and Cajun went and checked out the B bomb site. They're going to push Zipnix. They want to be aggressive on him, but smart. Look at this. He gets the first kill and he falls back cold. I mean, he's just bloodthirsty. Hunts him down.
Yeah.
And now they're going to get that bomb planted. They have control of Bankside. They have control. And Cajun is going to be on a retake.
Yeah, it's so important. He's using their manpower there, forcing Zipnix down. And now it's a 2-on-1. But Fallen still is very low on HP indeed. Cajun B now on towards the bomb site, lacking that kit, which is towards the bank area. Needs to find his first kill. If he can get this one down, it becomes very viable, but it's Cold Zero that lands a headshot. You can hear the room erupting now. And Luminosity started off very aggressively there towards middle. Locked down the setup from Astralis, and then just took advantage of that man advantage they had. The fact that they actually got towards bank and pushed Zipnix down. How do you find that second kill? Would have been
all over
Astralis back into it. And the fact they got him down to 2 HP as well, it's so gutting for them. But still, it's Luminosity taking the pistol here, and they're going to have three rifles and two MAC-10s going into round number two. There's no force spotting as such from Astralis. They have got a scout on this device, which is interesting. I wonder if he actually invested into that.
I think Dupree invested into it.
He's got $800 left. It's not like he had a really conservative buy himself.
Pretty sure Dupree invested into it so that come the fourth round, device can still hopefully have that AWP.
Yeah.
The rest of them are invested till about $800 to $1,000. It's the pistols, it's no armor, deagles. We'll see what they can make of it. And this is where Luminosity shines. These anti-ecos with these MAC-10s can be very effective. And all of a sudden, Taco overextends himself. The only one on that side of the map. He gives up an AK-47.
That's a chance there from Dupree. Can be very efficient with the Desert Eagle. Doesn't land the shot there on Fur. He capitalizes that MAC-10. And as looking like an A commitment coming in from the Brazilians here. Smokes towards the bomb site. The bomb is coming into the prefaces of the site as well. His device jumping, trying to make something land there, but it's not going to happen this time. Carragher does find a killer towards Cold Zero, but that's about all he'll get here by the looks of things if he gets dropped as well. And that's the round over. Just Zipnix remaining, but with the AK in hand, going to be stuck in a pretty difficult situation now, making his way towards bank.
I wonder if this is a situation maybe where he would consider falling back and giving it over to someone next round for some light armor. Maybe device, since he didn't really invest too much into this.
Carragher does have 2K, so he's going to be Zipnix. Probably looking for a kill here, seeing whether he can actually damage the economy of the terrorists. I think at this stage, saving the AK would be good. It's not like it's going to win them around, but definitely could have some impact here if they were to able to calculate the stacks.
Or just simply take it away from LG, force them to rebuy it. But you can already see there's one member, that's Fur, who's already circling around Zipnix, trying to make sure this AK-47 gets back into their hands by the end of this, when all is said and done. And there's no way Zipnix is prepared for this. So smart play from Fur to get that. The bonus money also picks up the AK for the next round, so they really don't lose too much in the end. Just two MAC-10s in the armor.
It's going to be pretty much straight up eco here, you'd imagine, from Astralis. Can't really justify much more than maybe a couple of P250s. That's been to round number three. Luminosity still have one player on the MAC-10. He becomes a reconnaissance player at this point. It means he can go into tight situations first, through some choke points, throw himself into a site and see if there is a stack there. As we said before on Dust 2, if a player like this against another player does go down, you're only really giving away an MAC-10. It's not too much of a big deal, and he's potentially going to find a couple of kills with that play anyway.
Also Fallen just on the P250, not investing in any kind of an SMG or rifle, wanting to have as much money as possible into the next round. Dupree's been found out. Luminosity has been very aggressive towards Party, towards Fountain, and then they seem to slow things down when they get right outside bathrooms.
Indeed. Well, it's going to be working out for them as well. Find to kill them towards Device. 5-3 now. The CTs don't really have much to work with here whatsoever. This could be holding up on the side to be carrying. Maybe find a kill here, but does get taken down by Fur. And that's the round over at this point. Maybe you can get a consolation kill, but not meant to be. Zipex now, USP in hand, has been discovered as well. He will be dropped. Clean sweep there for Luminosity. 3-0. Have a look at the cash coming in. It's going to be Device. He can get the AWP for sure. And this is when, okay, yes, Carrigan bought it. I guess he's just swapping it over. This is actually, for me, Device's best map. This is where he really comes alive on the CT side with the AWP. He's so dynamic, so aggressive, and it seems to hit every single shot that's presented to him. But the problem is, you've got Fallen as well. He's going to know exactly how Device plays, and it's going to be a real interesting battle going forward.
This fourth round as well, we mentioned on Dust 2, it's so precarious for the CT side. Their money is still not very strong. You see Carrigan has no nades to work with. They have one kit on Cage, and they're very quickly on the CT side going to be running out of these smokes, out of these flashbangs. So they have to put them all to huge effect. And still, look again how aggressive Luminosity already has these angles covered. They get right outside bathrooms, and they're just ready to take all of this over. They've already forced back Astralis from Long.
Yep.
That was Dupree there, and he's running back. He's booking it.
This is normally the objective of the default, is just to get control of Long, then towards Bathroom as well. They've actually managed to obtain those in the first 20 seconds. Push the CTs right back to the site here. There is a boost on towards the APC. That's Device looking for that first kill. Can just about see if that smoke. They do boost up in the flower, but that helps things out. It does not land the shot this time, though. And now, with how many smokes they've got remaining? They've got four smokes remaining, Luminosity. They've taken away the vision as well. They could go for a full execution here. You can see Carrigan knows he can't let that be a possibility. He needs to find a kill here just to stop that set piece being so effective.
A little unfortunate Device. That's an opportunity miss out towards Long. That was a clear shot for him. And now Kerrigan's stuck forward. Fallen is going to have the angle. So Kerrigan, he's here till he dies, essentially. He's got his teammates to help him out, maybe with a little bit of flashbangs when he calls for it. Oh, and he comes out right at the right moment. Fallen has a nade in his hand. There's a small mistake. And now he can try and fall back, but he's got to play behind the smoke. He gets one more. This is too much. And a third from Kerrigan. Almost a fourth as well. What a big-time play.
Yeah, it was absolutely huge. Oh, Luminosity running away with this one. It's going to be Taco and FNX to finish things off. 25 seconds, but Device hits the headshot, and Dupree finishes it off. I don't know how Astralis got back into that round, but Carrigan with the godlike play. Like I said, as soon as Luminosity have that control of bathrooms, middle and long as well, they can fully execute with the wall of smokes under the bombsite, get a plant down, that should be the round over, but it's Carrigan just denying that. Faces at the perfect time there, catches the one player out with some fortunate timing in his favor, then gets a really nice spray down the next two, and does heavy damage to the fourth as well, so that's all about the in-game leader there, Carrigan, stepping up and delivering what was required.
Yeah, all 20 bullets as well, some precision there from Carrigan. That's really, really sick, especially that he wasn't traded out. Taco goes for that shot, almost lands it, jumping.
That used to be like a common booster, jumping up, you actually could get away with that quite a lot before the patch came in recently. Well, not recently, a few months ago, but still, and then that's actually a really scary jump. Yeah, this is a really scary jump now. A lot of top players will hit that. So you have to be quite careful with that jump towards that plank. But here we go then, Astralis do get himself in a position where it's avoided that first gun round loss, but still, full reset could be coming in.
And Taco, after going for that shot on the jumping player, he just gets himself in position over towards short sewer, so he's essentially, he basically just sits here for most of this round. This is going to be something where he keeps control of the sewers, he lets the rest of his team work the map, and if they choose to fall back, or if they feel the need to fall back down the stairs and switch things up over towards the B bomb site, he has that control, so they can feel confident in the rotation.
You're absolutely right. It's a very common position for the CT to reposition themselves once they know the terrorists are committed towards A, but here comes the smokes now. Looks like Carrigan once again looking confident after his previous round. Wants to keep applying the pressure towards the terrorists here, but they have got control of bathrooms, at least on the terrorist side. And Carrigan pushing through with a flashbang here. This is an audacious move. Get found, not just yet, but surely going to be taken down here. Surely the best you can get is one frag. Does manage to ding FNX as well, but let's say, I think give them the advantage here.
I think audacious play was an understatement.
Yeah.
That was incredible, actually, for him to be making that kind of a play. And that's all together information. He gets a kill, which is great, but he finds things out. He sees at least two players there, and you can see it's allowed a little bit of a cheat. That next player, Device, is going to be a quick rotate. Dupree on a quick flank as well as this B hit comes on. There's only 7 seconds left. Luminosity, this round's over. Even if they get the kills here, no time for the plant.
Yeah, they're done.
They stall themselves out.
They want this kill for and after this timer as well. It'd be absolutely amazing if they can do this, but he will be surviving behind that pillar just about. And you can hear Astralis joining in with the chance now as well. They're going to find their second one here after the 3-0 deficit. So money still not going to be fantastic if Luminosity, but they did save the AWP. It's always very tempting to invest into this one with the Tech Nines. We'll see what they can do with this. They are going to have all joined by a couple of upgraded pistols. They're not forcing into the round. Not going to have the armor or the utility to work with here. So they're just going to be taking the more conservative approach.
Yeah, and then they're going to allow Fallen some time to try and find a pick with this AWP. It's all they've got. So I mean, slow things down. Someone kind of protect him. He's going towards short, and there is Device. Ends that very, very quickly. No fun for Fallen.
Yeah, that was the boost this time. CT's reading that quite well. Take down the AWP. And we'll see if any dangerous wall bangs come in. Not meant to be this time, but Attacko picking up the AWP. So we'll see what he can do here. He'll be edging in towards Monster Tunnel, but that is also denied. As Astralis smoke him out here, looking like it's be a 3-3 here. I'm not really sure what their options are going to be. Now Astralis know the AWP is down. They're probably going to adjust themselves and just make the Terrors work for this. They have got four players committed to the B side of the map and the bomb down towards T-spawn at the moment.
Moving into the next round, the plan for Luminosity, or maybe not even next round, maybe just the future rounds, at some point they're going to have to deal with the fact that Kerrigan is remaining so aggressive on that highway next to bathrooms.
There's a kill here potential. Let's see what he can do. Taka did spot him on that B site. They've got nothing to lose here. Might as well wait out for it, but it's Device taking him down. That's the next orb dropped. Zipex finds a kill on Definex as well. That's the round over. Just called Zero now. Potential trying to save this weapon. I don't think he probably can, but let's see what he decides to do. One about the T-spawn now, the CT has pushed through, that's going to be Cajun taken down. And 38 seconds to play with.
I'm not sure you want to save the weapon in this situation. I think you want the money more than you want to save it. Although this is great damage dealt no matter what happens from now on.
If he's finding kills, that's extra money every single time, right? So I guess it's something to work with. I guess I think saving the orb is always going to be viable, but it's not going to happen. It's going to be Kerrigan that finds the final kill. And 3-3 for Astralis now. Pretty clean rounds for them as well. But their money still hasn't got to the stage yet, but it's swelling. They still are in a precarious position where they have to reinvest all the grenades every time. It's quite late stages of the round. They're actually winning it. So you can see after the reinvestment, they are on average about just over 2k, I'd say. So still in a difficult position. That's the smoke from Kerrigan towards Monster Tunnel. It slows down any rush coming in from the terrorists here. And they're actually in a fight themselves. And it's actually smokes that'll work out nicely because they look like they are going to go for a fast B attack here. All five players committed to portion of the map.
No map control. And Device and Dupree actually pushed up pretty far towards Fountain. And they saw absolutely nothing. So you're going to see Kerrigan already cheating on the rotate over towards this B bomb site. So is Device. They're going to be here very quickly. Cajun just has to hold on. And he gets blinded at the worst possible moment. Zipnix is the next one up. He falls. But there's Kerrigan on the quick rotate. Massive trades down to a 2-on-2 so quickly.
Yeah, this is the thing. As soon as you commit five players to the B side of the map, you need to be acting quickly. They know they didn't really have much presence on the map, so just had to go with this one. 2-on-2, and it's going to be the HP advantage going towards Astralis here. Here comes the retake now. Decent flashbangs come in. Cold Zero waiting beneath that window. First frag will be very important. It's needs to capitalize now. Device, AWP, and one smoke. You feel like you can't really do much about this now. He has been taken out of the equation. As time ticks away, this is the Brazilian's round to lose. They can even sacrifice a player and still win the round at this point.
Yeah, I don't even think Device is going to go for it. He's already decided to save, just waiting to see if anyone's going to try and push and take this AWP away from him. So Luminosity get their fourth. A heavy play towards the B bomb site. I mentioned they were going to have to find a way to neutralize Kerrigan over towards bathrooms, and they just say, screw it, we're going to the other side of the map.
Yep.
They get around that way, even with the jump and the information on Astralis on that rotation. It was very nice for them to find that intel with Device and Dupree, just not able to get back in time.
That's the thing, they actually had a perfect read on it. Like you said, Kerrigan with a fast rotation. He found one kill, but it just wasn't enough. The trade going in Luminosity's favor. Round 8 down. Like I said, the money, even after winning 3 rounds in a row, isn't fantastic for Astralis. And see one player, that's going to be Kerrigan. It was actually Dupree who was on the pistol, but he's like, Kerrigan stepping out, you know, man, I'll take the hit. I'll go on the pistol. You hit the rifle. You're my star player.
Yeah, that Dupree and Device duo, you want to get it started. Cold is going to be aggressive. Goes for that jump shot. There's a good shot from Device. Doesn't get the kill, but does the damage. The smoke is going to slow things down. He's going to be able to fall back, although Fallen was in the open. It looked like he might have an opportunity to pre there.
He
gets double kills, and Kerrigan's feeling very smart at the moment after trading that gun away.
Yeah, he actually did some damage on towards Fur as well, so they have got the man advantage and HP. So it's Cold Zero out, boosting himself onto the flower bed towards Long. And interesting enough, though, it's actually Taco towards the B side, edging his way in towards Short. And we have got a player there for the CTs as well. That's Cajun watching Monster Tunnel. So this could be a very interesting exchange. Cajun in actually the advantageous position right now.
Well, Zipnix is actually up top watching for that play towards Short, so Cajun's actually covered at the moment. Taco's not being too aggressive, but once again, this just comes down to the fact his positioning is just there because Cold and Fur are going to throw a bunch of smokes over towards the A bomb site. Looked like they were going to rotate, but what they did, they pulled Zipnix away. So now that they've thrown this, they say, all right, Taco, this is your time to make a play. We pulled that second player over, see what you can find, and I don't think he's aware whatsoever that Cajun is to his right. He's going to win that battle, though. Now he's going to look to the right, but can't win the battle. The rest of Luminosity is already here, and they know exactly where Cajun is. He's got to try and hold on, and now he readjusts. And he's going to win that battle. He loses it initially, but just down to Fern. He did not have the HP to walk up for a trade.
Absolutely. He's got 22 with the bomb in hand, trying to do what he can here in the 3 versus 1. If you get a plant down, that'll be a miracle. But it's going to be Device to get the final kill. And that should be a pretty difficult situation in terms of the economy for Luminosity there, as they do have a full reset. Just $1,400 coming into their accounts this round. And it's Astralis bouncing back here and tying things up at 4-4.
I like that play from Luminosity. Those smokes put pressure on A, and Zipnix just kind of takes his attention off. He has to trust that that might be the execution late, you know, a desperate 3-on-4 yeah. execution.
This is a really strong position from Cajun. I feel like that's when yeah. you're left there to anchor by yourself, it's obviously a bit all in, but it worked out very well in that sense because they actually came up towards short. He found the first two frags somehow, and it's actually forced Luminosity onto an eco now. So three Tech Nines, Glocks. Not really much to work with. Dupree going to town here. Gets the double spray down. Cajun chiming as well. Dupree drops in the end. And Fallen taking a ton of damage there. So the round is decided. They're trying to inflict some financial crisis towards the CTs right now. I'm not going to get too much here. We have got an M4 picked up for FNX. Let's see what we can do with this one. Towards the bathroom, spraying wildly. Does take down Kerrigan, but down to 26 HP. Surely this is over now.
Should be. Device missed a shot earlier. That's what allowed Kerrigan to fall, but no huge loss there. It's just the MP9.
Damn. Thing is, Luminosity love that weapon. I don't know if you noticed recently, but it seems that players like Fern and FNX, they actually take that into gun rounds pretty happily.
They're huge fans of the SMGs these days.
It's kind of nuts how we're seeing that more and more, especially the UMP. Like 2016 has been the rise of that weapon.
The armor pan is pretty nice to have.
Yeah, of course. Like it's always been viable, but it seems like just recently, like, more and more teams are happy to take that gun into gun rounds and just have the extra utility. It's kind of funny how it all works out, but still. Luminosity still don't really have enough to work into this round. They've got the PT-50s, Tech Nines, Deagles, bit of body armor, smokes, and the bomb heading towards long. All five players, in fact, heading towards this area of the map, hoping they can potentially find Device boosting up maybe or catch them in transition with nades out. Could be making their way there pretty clean.
Yeah, a double save out of Luminosity, so their economy has been in a rough spot. But, I mean, it is important to note, T side of Overpass already with four rounds. That's not bad. So they still have some time to play with this.
Only one gun round so far, to be fair, after winning the pistol, but... Obviously,
that's a luxury they didn't have on Dust 2, so yeah. They'll be happy to take this so far. But yeah, sure. They've got to start getting some gun rounds on the board because this is just going to be a wash. Dupree and Kerrigan manning the fort. Doesn't even look like they're going to get a single kill out of it. Definitely not a plant.
There it is. Pretty simple affair now for Astralis. They should have a buy in the banking. So yeah, Device has got 10k. That's fantastic for Europa to have that kind of cash rolling.
That is the one thing you talked about. It's a double save, so they could get this double up setup. So that's for switching to on the T side, which is something we don't often see out of Luminosity. Maybe feeling a little bit desperate at the moment, trying to come up with something tricky.
It's something you don't really see on Overpass in general.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like it's an AWP on T side. Overpass is like, it's not exactly you see every single round, but to see two of them, that's pretty impressive. We'll see what they can do with this one. Device going aggressive, of course, towards middle. The spot towards the fountain doesn't spot anything yet, but Astralis on the... Oh, what's this? I like this from Kerrigan. This could be very interesting considering the setup Luminosity got here. So Dupree in towards the connector. Kerrigan pushed amazingly this close into no man's land.
Well, and Device is watching behind Kerrigan. So if Fur ever tries to wrap around Kerrigan, Device has that angle. They even have one player in stairwell, Dupree, ready to back them up if need be. So Dupree's guarding Kerrigan. I mean, Dupree's guarding Device. Device is guarding Kerrigan, and it's all to Kerrigan to make the play. There's the nice shot from Device.
And Kerrigan now just waiting for the reface to see if there's a reaction to the terrorist, but Device doesn't even need him. He's going to town right now. Gets a shot on Cold Zero as well. That's one of the orbs dropped, and 5-on-3. The CT's now still heavily committed. It's Kerrigan who's happy to stay in that aggressive position. Look at Dupree right now.
Oh, my word.
Okay. Does that both through the door? Like, was that?
There was a hole in the door, so okay. He spotted one player and just sprayed it, and he kills both of them, and that's...
Why not?
That's heartbreaking. That is just Luminosity getting entirely destroyed in that round. Nothing they could do.
I told you, this is Device's playground, man. This is the one of the maps.
That was sick.
He goes absolutely ham on this map. Like, he's actually, I think in terms of like raw AWPing on this map especially, this is the one I feel like he's potentially one of the strongest AWPers.
But we talked about at times, and it's always come up when we see Astralis have struggles in towards, you know, the semifinals. They seem to lose some kind of edge. They seem to lose that kind of winning, killing instinct.
Yeah.
And a play call like that for Kerrigan to push up that far, that is a killer instinct. Decent nade does damage to FNX, and there
it is. While we saw this kind of throwaway round here, that's an interesting topic in itself with Astralis, right? That's the plays they're not calling when they get very close on the CT side to winning games. If they get in that, oh, don't throw the game mentality, instead of like, oh, let's go win, they're sitting back and thinking, oh no, what if we lose that round because we did this? That's what separates winning games and losing them in those sort of situations. You still need to be able to have the balls to make those calls and actually be aggressive and take the game towards them. That's what wins you rounds. But anyway, this is getting interesting. Going to be a 3-on-3. Device is finally killing towards Fallen, and he will be finishing things off here. Continuing his strong form he's shown throughout the series. It's just going to be Taka remaining now in the 3-versus-1. He has got the bomb. Not really much grounds to plant.
Yeah, Cajun's ready, though. The cleaner. The cleaner is prepared.
Where did that nickname come from?
That came from Katowice. They had those show matches, the pros against
thing.
Joes.
Oh, no, yeah, the 5-on-1 thing, right?
And Cajun actually told us that he wanted his nickname to become the cleaner.
Can you request your own nickname? I don't think that's a thing.
Yeah, but it's such a weird, silly nickname to ask for that I feel like we have to... Like, who wants to be called the cleaner?
I don't know. I'm not a fan of it. I don't think I'll ever be calling them that. But still, I respect it.
Cutler wants to be called the Apocalypse.
The Apocalypse?
Yeah.
Okay. That's a nice one. Oh, okay. Device. He's in, like, fifth gear right now.
And this is back to that point made on Dusty. Your Opera on the CT side being so very mobile, so many different positions, deep towards playground, this time towards B. He's been towards bathrooms and towards a fountain. So, I mean, he's got Luminosity guessing at the moment.
There's so much more to an Opera than his raw skill to be able to find those shots. We'll probably touch on that a little bit more.
And look at what that kill has done, because that's Taco. That's the player who on a Luminosity, oh, that's a good trade by a Fallen. But that's that Taco player, he's been over towards the B bombsite, manning down in case they want to fall back towards the B site. Now that he's gone, they don't really have that option.
Occasion though, he's actually made it towards T spawn. He's actually all the way in the back here. The fly and the ointment to what seemed like a successful campaign here from Luminosity. He's actually making this all the way into a playground. Could find them here if they don't react soon. It just needs the CT teammates to show a little bit of presence. Say to Carrigan right now, just throw a flashbang, fire some shots. I'm coming in. Let's see what just worked out. Occasion, you can't see it right now, but I assure you it's happening. There it is. He gets the first kill.
Just falls away. Now he's got Luminosity guessing.
He's in the playground as well, so he's actually just readjusted perfectly. There's so many angles for the terrorists to check here.
That's a good read by Cajun as well, seeing that Taco is the one dead. I guarantee they watched the demos and they knew Taco would be in those spots, and they said he's the one who's always watching for that flanker towards B. Once he falls, Cajun takes the opportunity. And now just by surviving, he's got Luminosity so paranoid of behind, and there he is pouncing a second time.
So sick. That was actually a perfect play from him. Like the CTs weren't facing at all, was waiting for the terrorists to make the next move, and Cajun, when he got in that position, they knew they'd won the round at that stage. It was so perfect from him. And like I said, once you get that first kill, he kind of fades away a little bit, gets in a really advantageous position. The terrorists are a little bit rattled. They're not really sure what's going on. Faces again from a different angle, gets a second kill, locks it down, and it's 9-4 here. Astralis with a heavy lead going into round number 14. We see a difficult buy for Luminosity. Galils, Tech Nines, they have got utility. I'd say going towards B here, maybe a little set piece, wall of smoke, try and get a bomb down. The rush for them worked before. That's the only gun run they've actually won here. It's a full-on B rush, really.
Yeah, well, they gotta hope it works again. This time, there's no cheat on the rotation from Astralis. There's no intel. They didn't get as aggressive towards Fountain as they did last time, so Zipmix and Cajun have their work cut out for him. Zipmix is blind at the moment, waiting for someone to come through Monster. His teammate has fallen. There's one kill. Can he get the second? That would be huge if he could find Fallen, but he can't.
Yeah, it's the contact play. Get as close as they can towards the entrance of the site. Simple flashbang comes over, and they work together and smother the CTs on the bomb site. And Zipmix manages to find one, but he's traded straight away. And now the CTs need to work out, is this worth going for? It's got to be a 4-on-3. I feel like they've got so much cash. It's definitely worth it just to even find the bonus kills here. As the bomb ticks away, Device just get Molotoved out. And it's Carrigan just dancing on the edge of that fire. And it's the bomb now. A difficult situation. Dupree, Monster Tunnel, it's going to come down to him. He'll be very influential here, but he's dropped by Fallen.
I think this is the safe call now. I think Astralis stuck around long enough to say if we get this kill, we go for it, but they didn't. Device is at least going to cover his retreat with that one kill, but a fifth round now for Luminosity and a second gun round on the board for them. That's, so five rounds. Is that going to be worth it? Is that going to be enough? Worth it was an incorrect phrase.
You're asking one of the questions you hate, Moses.
I know. I am, actually.
Literally one of your trigger questions.
Let me be the first person to apologize for that. Well, you know, you threw Jaden around at me earlier, so I feel like I got to come back at you with something.
Well, a good response you can give them in that situation, Moses, you can always say, well, only good questions deserve good answers.
Oh, okay.
That's an Oscar Wilde quote, so you can chuck that at them sometimes, sound a little bit more intellectual. So save that for next time.
Write that down.
Anyway, last round of the first half. It's going to be double orb set up for Astralis. I think that's the first time we've seen it. And so it's going to be Cajun B on the orb this time. I feel like that's a good adjustment. That's been a problem. The only rifle rounds have actually won. It's that simple contact B play. So Cajun B trying to adjust. He does get spotted. And he's going to be swarmed as well. The contact play working out once again for Luminosity. Zipex towards a barrel error. Sure, he can't get another, but he does somehow. Headshot lands onto FNX, and he's still alive. He's going to get a third. Actually, doesn't happen, but you can see a fast rotation from Dupree coming in towards short.
Yeah, a little unfortunately, he flashed himself, and with the aggressive stance of Fur, that's a big-time play. Pushing all the way up, finds Kerrigan. They know Dupree is short. They know more than likely he's there, but Device is going to go with the op from above. Raining death. And now he's able to cover Dupree, actually. He's got to find the timing. He's got to watch his own flank, but Dupree now going to be the one to get aggressive, and he falls to Fur.
Well, Device now, obviously the last round. No reason not to go for it. The smoke is deployed on the site, and the Molotov should be extinguished. Actually, it does land as he comes down now with the CZ. I'm able to get a rifle, but it's Fur. Decent position, aggressive, of course. And after winning the pistol, it's going to be Luminosity finding 6 rounds on a terrorist.
Yeah, 4 kills for Fur in that round. That's big stuff. So 3 gun rounds for Luminosity, 3 off the back of the pistol and the 2 ensuing anti-ecos. And it ends 9-6 for Astralis. So switching sides now.
I think all the rounds they won in gun rounds were towards the B side, every single time.
Yeah, it was those contact plays.
They couldn't get rolling on the T side. Their defaults weren't really working out for them. They couldn't get the executions. They just said, well, let's go towards B as soon as we get close enough towards shorter monster tunnel. 2 flashbangs over and let's swarm the site. Very simple, but it's effective.
Yeah, well, heaven forbid I say this. I mean, I think, forgive me, Lord, but Sadicus was right on the desk. He said that B bomb set was going to get exposed from Astralis.
# Sadicus was right. You heard it at first.
And I hate myself for that.
Well, I think we have a little break coming in here, so we're going to jump in the second half very shortly. Don't go anywhere. In a very decent position to take this 2-0. And we'll see how this one goes down. They're going to have 2 smokes here. Carrigan and Cajun B wielding those. And a little Molotov as well, potentially for the post-plant situation. I would say that suggests a B plant, considering you have the Molotov. Makes it much easier to throw onto the site. But let's see what they decide to do here. Going in towards that short tunnel and connector here. Just getting control of towards water. And one player towards monster tunnel as well.
This is a lot of manpower to devote to the stack for the entire time. And yeah. Unfortunately, it's going to work out for them. They have the right call. Here come the nades. Smoke up top. Flashbang blinds Cold initially. They think they spotted him, but he gets a kill anyways. That's a nice shot. He goes for more. And there's Fur over towards the boxes, or towards the barrels. He finds a kill. Dupree now pushing up. This has been slaughtered. What a setup. And I don't think they must not have realized that Fur was there the entire time, because nobody cleared him out. He had time to reload and even go for a second kill.
Like you said, a lot of manpower dedicated towards B. So it's actually a stack towards the back there. Got Cold Zero the first kill. He drops down and takes a lot of aggro for his teammate from barrels to kind of light up the scoreboard as well. missed. They didn't get the bomb now, did they? So it's going to be difficult now for Astralis to get into this one. They're not going to be force buying, though. So just going to be having some upgraded pistol. A lot of teams, if you don't get the bomb down in the first, actually, it's more than likely actually force up fully in the second with the Tech-9s. Not going to be going for that one this time. Going to be going for the Famuses.
Well, you know, I mean, Astralis has talked a lot about how they're going to be making a lot of changes moving forward.
Okay.
I know they've talked about their map pool, how they're going to try and embrace Nuke and everything like that. But I
and
think maybe
Cobble
this
as well. I think.
Yeah, and this might be one of those changes they're making is maybe being a little bit more conservative when it comes to their economy, at least going into the fourth rounds, ready to get on a winning streak.
Yeah, it's like after the pistol on the T side, I'm not against the idea of forcing the second as long as your AWP doesn't. I think it's fine. But regardless, not really much to report this round. Simple procedure here for Luminous Sleep. Just completely taking them down. It's going to be 9-8. And they're clawing back into this one. We'll see what Astralis brings to the table this round. They've got not really much grounds to work with once again. So it's going to be presumably 9-9 here. So Luminosity bouncing back and making this a very interesting affair.
Yeah, and they absolutely needed to do this. And this is one of those rounds you often see Luminosity. They do a very good job of actually, as someone knifes his teammate, Ferg, it's knifed down to 92. Not too shabby. But a lot of people, or a lot of times on LG, will make sure that their SMG is the people to make that first contact. This time, I mean, it's just a B-rush, so it's like, why not throw a couple nades at Monster, get some massive kills, and there's the UMP for the cleanup. Cold ends with 4 kills, but only 2 get the bonus. And he even throws away the UMP. He just says, no, I don't want it.
I don't want that gun. Get it away from me. They know the AKs are coming out this round anyway.
Yeah.
The UMP, although we like the whole bonus round potential, it's still, just at this point, just win the round. It's not even about making the economy larger.
Oh, yeah, and then he just goes flat out for the second AWP. And we saw how impactful this was on Dust2 on the Luminosity CT side. So right off the bat, Astralis is going to have a tall task ahead of them.
Absolutely. Some aggressive play here from Fergus with a connector area. It does seem to be aware. There is someone on that right-hand side. Doesn't really want to fully commit to it there, but it is Cold Zero picking up that first kill. Drops device. No AWPs here for Astralis. It's a straight-up rifles. Occasionally answers back. That's a kill towards that connector area. So still 4-4. We'll see what the reaction is from the CTs. Still have the double AWPs going into this one. And 4 smokes for Astralis. So if they can get some map control, potentially could go for the full execution. But doesn't know that that'll be happening anytime soon. The bomb's still down towards T-spawn.
They have a lot of faith in Taco at the moment. They have rotated so far away from Cold. Rotated all the way back towards Long A. And now he's going to be grouped up with Fallen. So both of the ops essentially looking
yeah,
at the
right.
same thing over towards the A bomb site.
This is kind of nuts, really. And Dupree's got fully up towards short as well. He's just listening out for footsteps, see if he can get anything out of this in terms of intel. Occasion B with that pick towards connector. Can almost assume there'll be no one else there. Stacking out does get some backup in the form of Cold Zero. So they are adjusting slightly. He's watching towards short. Cold Zero at the barrels is watching Monster Tunnel as well. And we'll see what kind of execution comes in here. Like I said, 4 smokes and Molotov. So. Hello. Ooh.
I wanted it so badly.
No.
Oh, that's what a turnaround.
Yes, that was definitely an opportunity there. But Dupree does manage to get the kill back, and it's going to be Cold Zero now to defend them with the AWP. Doesn't have vision, there's a decent smoke. Make it 2 of them, so they've got a definite opportunity to plant now.
Oh, and here's where it becomes tough for a double-up setup. Well, this boost, he almost had them lined up, but they spot it, and they break up just in time. But 2 AWPs having to retake, and that's going to help out. Zipnik's wandering right into it around the smoke. Kerrigan, though, has got such a good position.
Yeah, this double AWP play, you're absolutely right. Still very difficult. They're waiting for an opportunity for someone just to give them a face at this point. But Carrigan, I love this position from it. Should be able to get one, and surely the no-scope. You can feel it coming. Doesn't land this time. And it's going to be Cold Zero with the USP to finish things off. And it's just Carrigan with that real cheeky position in there. And it's just such a difficult proposition. And players like Fallen, though, you almost feel like he's going to hit that no-scope every single time for some reason. Doesn't land. Him on this occasion, but it's Astralis taking the first gun round here.
And now Luminosity, they have to buy into this round. So they're going to be very, very light. Fur's going to drop an AWP over. That's going to be a Fallen. Cold stuck on the Famas and Taco. He picks up an M4. So they're bought out. They only have 2 players on 50. Everyone else is at 0. So this is a big round in terms of who can take control of this map. And Luminosity desperately needs it.
Absolutely. Device back on the AWP himself. First time on the T-half, of course. Let's see what he can do with this weapon. Not too much aggression from the CTs here. A little difference in the setup, though. We have got Fallen towards Long on the flower bed. Looking out for that first pick, and he's being backed up by FNX as well. He's watching the bathrooms for him. So Flashman comes over. Fallen, though, intelligent, doesn't fire off a shot. Wants to give the illusion he's not there, but there it is. His position's given up now. Has to fall back. Actually, maybe staying a little bit longer here. Wants to flash himself over, maybe a little pop flash, and have his teammate face at the same time.
Yeah, I was going to say, maybe I think he might just not be falling back because he wants to be there to back up FNX if it's needed.
Let's see what he can do with this one. Flashbang will be coming in. And this is presumably the face from him. Not great, though. Oh, somehow device has not hit that. I thought he had that shot all day long.
is a game of chicken from Device.
Yeah.
And I mean, this is smart though from LG. They've done the damage. They know they've dinked him, but why face again? Why risk him landing one of those op shots and just giving your team, you know, a huge, huge disadvantage into this round?
Well then, it's Dupree actually. He's made his way to the B site. I completely undetected here. This is kind of nuts. The CTs have allowed him to have it, but they are aware now. Smoke's coming in. The bomb moving planted, but somehow fallen. He gets the shot. He's in towards the window area. So that's the bomb dropped as well. He's rattling off. AWP goes through that smoke. Bomb is planted, but the man advances for the CTs.
And Device is still at Playground. He's got a long way to go. He's got to get on his horse before LG just gets in here. It's essentially a 5-on-3 at this bomb site. Device still on his way there, but Luminosity, they're being very calculated on this retake. Molotov, Molotov onto the bomb.
I think it was.
I think it got extinguished. Okay. But look at this. Zipnix now. He's got the angle. He sprays down two of them. That's a big play. FNX, though, he responds, and now it's Cajun on short. He's got to push up, and he finds one. They're not paying attention to him. They're still not on the bomb quite yet.
They are.
And he's got the second one, and now he's in the smoke.
One. Diffused.
Oh, he's going to get it. That is crushing for Astralis. And he's even going to clean out the last two members. Insult to injury.
That is a bit crushing. It was so hectic there. I mean, like I said, like when I was, I just focused on the defuse while you were calling the round. I just wanted to see what was going on. It was so many one-on-one exchanges, so many smokes and flashbangs going off. I just thought there's going to be someone in that smoke kind of being a little bit cheeky there. It's going to be Fallen, like you said, cleaning up the round as well with the PT-50. This takes away so much money from Astralis as well. You can see they are forcing into this one, trying to answer back and trying to reset Luminosity straight away here with the three Tech Nines, two AKs, all in at this point. It's a great opportunity for Luminosity to take control and take the lead for the first time in a while. As we go into round number 21, difficult situation. Looks like a contact B play from Astralis. Zipex leading the way, going for that first frag, lands it as well. Takes some Coldzera, and smokes have been deployed as well. Bomb will be coming in, and this is another retake opportunity for the CTs with his Device and Garrigan with those Tech Knights, taking them down. And somehow, after the last round, they bring it into a 5-on-2. Impressive stuff to bounce back. At this point, Fallen probably just wants to save the AWPs. This is a full reset for the CTs now. This will leave them on a double eco potentially here.
Yeah, you could almost feel how angry Astralis was after that last round. They started rushing and never let go of the movement key. They get all the kills so quickly. No one falls when they take that bomb site. They're all the way pushed up towards those hallways. Fallen had a lot of pressure put on the rotation, so it's going to be 11-10, and you're exactly right. I mean, Fallen will be able to have the... Oh, no. Zipnix, the dagger. Here it comes. He finds Fur. Can they hunt down Fallen as well?
They won the final boss. It's going to be Fallen surviving here. It would have been so sick if they could have taken him down as well. That would have been a definite double eco going forward, but now he has
the
orb.
It might still be.
It still is, but the fact that you have one of the world's best orbers with that weapon...
Yeah.
He can still make things happen. We see it time and time again, especially it seems like Navi. If Guardian saves an AWP, he can win you rounds. And they're looking like they're forcing into this, you know?
Okay. Yeah, they really are.
Okay, then. They're all in.
Well, they're saying we can't double save and give two rounds over. We have to at least contest it.
Exactly. And if they do win the round, that's another reset for Astralis. This is just a back-and-forth game right now, seeing who will break the serve first. And it's going to be Luminosity going aggressive, of course, towards shore, pushing it towards water. And we'll see how this one goes down. A very passive hold here from the Terror. It's going to be sending three players up towards long, uncontested for now. But the CT's getting tons of info here. They've pushed players off towards Monster, short, and they have players towards middle as well. So you almost guarantee, unless it's a very, very defensive hold, that the Terror is going towards long. There it is. The first pick comes in.
It's a nice shot by Fallen. I don't know if they saw anything, but Astralis is the perfect counter, though. Fast towards long, where there was essentially nobody for the longest time. Now they're hustling to try and rotate and to get in good positioning, but it's only against pistols at the moment. Shotgun's not even really involved. All four members of Luminosity, all five, excuse me, stuck behind these smokes, except for FNX. He's on a rotation. He's on a big flank.
That was dangerous for him, but it's going to be Coldzera to find the CZ kill. And now it is actually a two-man advantage for the CTs. We go into the next section. They've got one kit to play with. That's on Fallen. Look at FNX coming in towards long as well. They're pincering the bombsite here. Kills need to be found from the terrorists. It's going to be too much for them if they allow them to get this close to the bombsite. There it is. FNX from long. And Taco finds one with the PT-50 as well. Carrigan, 4-on-1 situation. Could do something with this, but he's such low HP. Spraying the bullets in. It's not enough. Fur finishes things off with the Mach 7. Diffuse comes in. I believe it's the player with the kit as well.
Yes.
So it's going to be fine. And what a round to bounce back. As I said, that will be the reset going back towards Astralis. They do get the bomb down, so it's not as devastating, but still, it's going to be AKs and Tech Nines if they do decide to do the same thing back. What a round. I told you, Moses.
Yeah.
If he has the AWP, there's always a chance.
What a buy from Luminosity with their backs against the wall. And to have that big of a risk with the investment, if that doesn't work out, they give such a strong hold to Astralis. But doesn't go Astralis' way. So Luminosity 11-11, and now they've forced him onto pistols.
Yeah, they've actually broken them this time. It's going to just be P250s, that's it. No utility, and they're not really rushing or committing to any side of the map. Just holding up in a default stance right now. I'm not really sure what the plan's going to be with these lesser weapons, just firing off some shots, given away they are on eco now, so the CTs don't really have to commit to any aggressive angles, just fall back and see what the next move is from Astralis. There it is, falling right back now. Just in these situations, you want to make sure you don't die by yourself. That's the key. Falling off, throwing away the AWP. Even if, I guess that's quite clever, even if he dies then, which he thought he might do, at least he throws the AWP in an unretrievable situation. This is something.
He almost gets caught there. Nicely done from Cole to transfer over to Zipnix after Dupree falls. FNX, it's all about timing because he's got Device walking right up behind him. Fallen's now closing the gap, but yeah, it looks like Luminosity has stabilized in this round. A little bit of danger early on. Nothing coming in the later stages of the round, oh, except for Device there. That's a nice shot on Fallen. Fallen never really felt comfortable in this round.
Moses, can you explain the whole 11-11 thing to me?
The whole, like the 11-11 Make-A-Wish thing?
Yeah. I think it's just because
there's four ones on the board.
Is that it?
Yeah.
There's no story behind it or history. It's just four.
Not that I know of.
Okay.
I mean, we
don't have that in the UK, and it's just you American guys see to bring that to the table. This is what it was. While we had it on screen, I want to get some information from you.
I mean, to be fair, the one Brit in this cast was the one who brought it up now.
Yeah. Well, there you go. What can you say about that one? There we go. Then it's going to be Astralis bouncing back with the AWP and Device with the AWP towards Playground right now, waiting for the CT aggression to come in. It's actually Fur by himself towards Long. Going to be flashed off, and he finds that first kill. That's massive from him. And no one going to be going for the refrag either. He smokes himself out, and that's the perfect round from him.
That's one of those plays you want to say, I don't like this play, because you're alone, and then he gets the kill and falls away safely, and you're like, all right.
It's as well recovered. In fact, he finds a kill and smokes it efficiently and gets out without even taking any damage. You can't really be angry at that.
It's a little unfortunate as well that he finds that because Taco falls on the other side of the map, and that's where you're kind of like, that's a bummer. That would have been a big advantage for him.
Indeed.
Still, though, the AWP have fallen in good position, although he's got to be... there's a certain timing on this that's got to be awkward. If someone comes from beneath, and you can see he had to check it, and the timing of it is just really unfortunate for Fallen.
And they both spotted each other as well now, so Cajun's not going to be facing that again. Get to the 50-second mark here. We'll see what the rest of the terrorists are up to. Kind of spreading themselves out. Device towards Long with the AWP. Just checking out bathrooms. Seeing if it's clear, yeah, it's going to be falling on towards that short area. He's now actually in a pretty bad position considering there it is. The first kill comes in, takes an FNX. Now it's Fur in the bathrooms, and he's out of position here, I'd say.
Well, what he does have is information. Here's the footsteps, and he'll have a quick flank if they go towards that B bomb site. And I don't think anyone's going to clear that. Kerrigan runs right by him. That's a free kill. Now he's got the read as well, and there's still a player. There's still Cold over at the B bomb site waiting on short, and the smoke's going to fade. He's going to find another free kill. Device trades that off. Right out of the smoke, Fallen is here though, the man with the AWP, and he nails it. What a critical shot to hit. 10 seconds left, Zipnix has got to put this down. A 1-on-2, and Fallen is going to rush him. He doesn't want to let this go, and he's going to find him right in the smoker. It's Fur to clean it up with the nade.
The alley-oop.
Luminosity, salvage a double AWP as well. Fur picks one up, it's going to be 13-11.
Nothing really separating these guys. Every time someone gets a pick, it's answered back straight away. But once again, it looks like Luminosity have broken the economy of Astralis. They're currently sat on about average of what, like 3.4k, maybe a little bit more. And it's going to be a difficult round going forward. We have got Zipex on almost 5k, so...
I'm not sure, you know... You always feel, I know this is a little bit that we get to sit outside the game, and as former players, you got to have a little bit of empathy for the situation. But Zipnix actually has a flashbang there, so if they actually throw one flashbang over towards just that cross, the defender might be guarding it. That could be a plant. Obviously, Fallen could somehow find the timing.
It's one of those high-pressure situations.
Yeah, with 11 seconds left, I mean, that's got to be... You can't be too critical of that.
Yeah, there's kind of panicking. Say, look, you need to get the bomb down, you need to get to the site. Let's just hope he's not there. Oh, God, he is. Oh, no.
Run the gauntlet.
Yeah, let's just hope for the best. It's looking like Luminosity now getting himself in a very... Oh, have we got a force buy?
No, I think it's just a minor half investment.
I was going to say, like, that would be kind of interesting. A couple of AKs and three.
I think that's what Semi calls them, right? Half investments.
I don't half think buys. I think it goes on Quasis, doesn't it? I think that's this whole thing. It's this whole setup.
Oh, boy. Glad we walked right into that one.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Nice.
We need to get terminology that's actually uniform across the board.
We do. That is one thing that we have slacked upon.
Yeah. Well, we're all the same cast as every single event. Surely we should be using the same terms, but you know what? Maybe it's nice to have a bit of personality. Anyway. Double loss now for Fallen and Cold Zero. It's going to be Device, though, with the headshot of the Desert Eagle. That's the aggression lockdown. And they don't have much to work with. They have picked up the M4. And there's a shot missed by Fallen. A little bit more to work with as they get some...
He's getting surrounded, though. Okay. Oh, it's Cold to get one. But there's Cajun. He comes around, and he might be able to get two kills here. Oh, no, not like this Luminosity. How many times do we see it? The bomb's getting planted. No one's covering him. Can he stop that? He can't. But he does get him on the exit.
Okay, then 3-on-2. Kerrigan with the M4 in hand. Here comes the retake from Taco and Fur. They have made their way onto the bomb side. They have got smokes and flashbangs here. So a smoke towards the bomb. Presumably going to be where they go with this one. As the bomb ticks away now. Need to find a couple of kills before they go for the defuse. There's a smoke on towards the... Oh, it's missed.
Oh, no.
That's horrible.
It's heartbreaking. Oh, that's so bad.
Okay, then, well, that becomes very problematic now. They do find the kill on towards Kerrigan. The bomb ticking away. Have to go for the full defuse. This kill has to happen. It is replied, and that's the round going in favor of Astralis. That one smoke, you feel like that could have been the difference maker there. There it is.
You okay. Never know. They had the angle out towards long, but, oh, Fur.
Definitely contributed. Oh, my
God. Yeah. This is rough. You can see he's, like, the distance is so awkward that he's trying to bounce it a little bit, and it just hits that lip.
Yeah, well, the fact is the smoke could have gone down. It makes things, it almost forces Astralis to come out of their hiding position at that point, right? So that's when it comes a little bit more interesting. At least you make them face at that stage when they hear the fake tap come in. When they have vision on the bomb, only one player has to face at that stage. But still, Astralis coming back just when they need it as well. Just Tech Nines swarming towards middle, and it's Fallen misses a couple of shots, and Device opening up that Desert Eagle headshot towards middle. Pretty impressive, but there it is. Astralis clawing on back. It's 13-12 now, and it looked a bit desperate for them.
Both economies shattered this late.
This
in
round
the game.
Is so huge.
Astralis is a little bit better off, but still.
Yeah, they wouldn't be able to buy regardless of just 1400 next round. So.
Well, you say that, but they just win with the Tech 9 armor. So.
True.
Why not just go for it?
Yeah.
The boost of Fallen, Device. Who's going to win this battle? Oh, that flashbang is perfect. And Fallen times it. Yeah, that was Dupree. He actually hits him through the board a little bit, down to 74 HP.
Straight to the dome of Dupree. Like I said. And Dust too. It's one of those things you're fully blind, might as well take a shot. And it's Fallen timing it perfectly. Gets a second as well. That's the AWP of Device. This is going to be crippling for Astralis going forward. It's going to be Luminosity at touching distance of map points. And presumably, Astralis has made the decision now. Do they go for this one? They're trying to save the AKs. Work out what's going to be the next move for them. So you do hit the 45 second mark. And we're getting a little bit more aggressive, gaining intel here as they push towards middle. Just leaving Fallen alone on the A site. Adjusting themselves towards B.
Here's what they do have, is that Luminosity, they're running out of utility. Two flashes and a nade, and now they've also playing very passive on this B bomb set. There are three members of Luminosity here. But if Zipnik can find a kill, which he can't, so now this might just be all over. Molotov is trying to protect the planter, and it's just Luminosity swarming. 14-12, no plant down for Astralis. Would have been huge to help out in their economy. You can see it there on the screen. It is not pretty.
That's the thing. Only get $1,400. Didn't get the plant down, so didn't even get the bonus $800. They've already used their pause here, and they're going all in. I guess they kind of have to. Like you said, it worked before.
Well, I think it's more so just don't let Luminosity get up towards 15.
Exactly.
I mean, they want to go for the win at the very least. But basically what this has done is, in this situation, if they can't win this round, it's going to be two force buys to kind of close down what could be Luminosity's last two rounds.
Let's see what they can do here. They're going to be swarming towards the B site, similar to what Luminosity presenting. Do they push through this Molotov? It doesn't look like they will. They're going to be slowing it right down here. Looks like LG have got a pretty decent read on here, dropping their utility as well. Smokes all over the place. Probably can get a plant down here, but it's still burn a great position.
Yeah, Kerrigan gets that first kill. First still can't find it. He sprang through the smoke. He's got to be very careful that no one bum rushes him right through. That Device wants to do it. He does get away in time, so that's smart play from first. Stays alive. The bomb is planted. It's going to be a retake. No utility on the Astralis side. All Tech Nines. There's rifles and there's some flashbangs and two smokes to work with for Luminosity. And this boost is going to try and find him some intel, but there's the opening kill from Taco.
Yeah,
that forces Cajun to make a play, and Luminosity should have this.
Yeah, literally nothing you can do. You've got no utility, no firepower. You've got the pistols hoping for the best. If you had AKs, you could have the crossfires and actually do some decent damage here. But these Tech Nines, it's like pea shooters, unless you're hitting them in the head. So.
I don't think I've ever heard anyone call a Tech 9 a pea shooter.
At that kind of range, when you've got terrorists, CDs coming, unless you're hitting headshots, it's very difficult to actually make that gun work for yourself. So especially if you've got orbs and boosts of AKs coming in, it can be very problematic.
The plant's going to help Astralis a little bit, but it's still going to be mostly pistols on their side. We have a Deagle on Cajun, we have Kerrigan with the Tech 9, Galil on Zipnik's Device gets the UMP, and actually Dupree is going to be the only AK.
Three rounds in a row required for Astralis just to take us to overtime here on the second map. Luminosity in a very strong position to take us to the third. We'll see how this one goes down. Fallen aggressive towards middle, boosting up above the smoke. Look at that first kill, of course, the headshot. Takes down Device. Great opening kill, and he gets a second as well. This guy is on fire right now, as he won't be falling back just yet as well. Fancy the third. It's going to be FNX dropping on the other side of the map. Zipex takes him, and still some signs of life here for Astralis, but not much, I have to say.
There's a very small window of opportunity, a glimmer of hope. That flashbang needs to be God tier. Taco's forced back, but